Hello everyone, how are we doing today? So in today's video, we're going to be going over how to make a custom ChatGPT tutor for your classroom or your study. So this semester I made some tutors for my anatomy and physiology classes and students have loved them. So I want to make this video to teach you, hopefully you know, other instructors, how to make these yourself. Now, just some caveats before we get into this. This does use OpenAI's ChatGPT, and to make a custom GPT, or that's what I use to make these tutors, it does require a pro or plus version, which is at this time $20 a month. So that is one caveat here. And a few months ago, the only people who could use custom GPTs were plus users as well. Now, free users can use them via a link or from the GPT store. However, they do have limits per hour or whatever. So it's about 8 to 10 interactions according to my students. And then there's like a couple hour cooldown. But tutor wise, I found that's enough interactions for the student to get, you know, decent interactions with the tutor for the help that they are looking for. So now, what sets these tutors apart? Well, they can be trained specifically on the book that you're using and your lecture notes. So how you actually teach in the classroom, which is really cool because the student can ask questions, they can refer to a figure in the text or something like that. Now, it does need some access to, you know, well, in terms of resources, if you are using a publisher-based book, you have to be careful of copyright stuff. You can't just throw in the publisher book in ChatGPT. But however, if you are using open access materials, let's see if we can find this open access. Here's open access anatomy and physiology, which is what I made one of my tutors out of already. But what I want to find one, kind of make one new here. Let's go to biology down here. So here they have all the instructor resources you can get. So some guides in there. But then here you can download a PDF of the book. And that is what you can then upload to this custom GPT tutor. So they're right there downloading a PDF. And I'll kind of walk you through how to make one of these now. So over here where your icon is, go to My GPTs, and then you can click Create a GPT. And then here is where you now create one. Now, you can type it all in, which is what I recommend, but you can also interact with the GPT and make one. It'll help you design the prompt and so forth. Now, I already have made the prompt for this, so I'll kind of show you how that goes. So here you make the name for it. So whatever the tutor name that you want to make, add a short description for what it does, and then the instructions. This is the, you know, the hard part. How can you, you know, make this prompt interact with the students in a meaningful, encouraging way, and hopefully not provide direct answers to the students. Well, after some time here, I'll show you this, my OpenStax AI anatomy and physiology tutor. So this is it all fully built here. I know I'm slightly in the way. So here I have the title of the description. So using the second edition, and then here is the big part. This is the prompt. So you're a friendly anatomy tutor for college level students. If a student copies and pastes a question, do not answer directly, but help direct them in it. And then here are key responsibilities, being positive and encouraging, compliment students in their efforts, and just, you know, all the traits of being a good, proper tutor. And then here, be sure to ask guiding questions so that lead the student to think critically and have them explain certain things. So even though the tutor might end up giving the answer to it, it's going to work that student to that answer. And then here, providing additional materials, readings, example problems, and so forth. And then, you know, clarify any misconceptions the student might have. And then engage students in more discussions about the material and explain their thought process and reasoning. And these are just typical dialogues you have for tutor trainings. And so why not just train the AI based on that, and use examples to illustrate concepts so that students can better make those associations. And then when the session is over, you know, end with positive comments and things like that. And then down here, it's extra notes. I know here you can't read this. Let me turn the camera off. You have access to PDF of the textbook in the knowledge database or via this link, because since OpenStax is online, you can actually share the URL in the tutor base here, and it can try to reference stuff from the online stuff and use this information to provide proper explanations of concepts and refer students to the correct sections and figures in the book. So it actually does a decent job at that. So if we come back here now, next part here is to make conversation starters. Now these aren't typically used, but it can give the student examples of how they can ask questions and so forth. So you can edit these and make them however you want. Then here is where you add the knowledge database files I was talking about. In this tutor, all I have is the textbook there, so it can reference that textbook or refer to the website up here as well. The rest of the stuff here, I did try editing these capabilities here to see if it allowed students to have more interactions, and it didn't make a difference. So they can generate images or do web browsing, and it doesn't matter that they have a free version. But the fact that it is free is important for student accessibility, and there is a paywall and if you want unlimited access, but there is a little cool down period. And like I said, I found my students, it's not a big deal for the interactions that we have. So there's the anatomy and physiology tutor. I could show examples there, but here I want to show you how I set up the biology tutor. Same thing here, I just changed a few words, and I will copy and paste this into the description of this video or just share a link to a Google Drive doc so that you have access to this prompt that I used here. And here down here, I just changed the link to the second edition of the biology book, and then here I changed anatomy to biology. So I only changed a couple things in this, and then here I said, you know, uploaded the biology textbook. And over here, you can test it. How does photosynthesis work? And it will shoot out an explanation. So this is, you know, a student is confused. It searches its knowledge right here, and then we'll explain that in detail. It takes a little bit, of course. And so we'll see what it outputs. And then, so now when it's outputs this, it's kind of trained on the textbook. So it's going to use similar word usage as the textbook will use. And again, this is just going right through photosynthesis, and you can stop it, interact with it, and so forth. And now I do want to add something here. It's like, I'm so confused, I will never understand this. So let's say you're a very frustrated student. How will it interact? So here it can break it down simpler, in more simpler terms, simpler examples. And then here's like, so let's tackle this together. So now you work through which one. First one. And like I said, it is now like interacting with a tutor. That's trained on material that you're working through. And so now, since it understands that you need a little bit more of a simpler breakdown of stuff, it's now using more comparisons here, like a conveyor belt, kind of like a turbine. So now it's, you know, it's bringing in more examples like that and not being as scientific in the discussion. If you notice one thing here, I don't have a photo. So over here, it's like, can you generate a profile image for this tutor? So you can interact with it and ask it to generate a profile image for this tutor. So I left this one blank on purpose here, so that it can create that. And I always did that by just creating here. Now it's generating a profile photo, and then it'll ask you if this is good and so forth. So we'll let this go for a second. And there it is. I'm not being picky here. And pretty simple. And so here, boom. Perfect. Let me know if you want any adjustments. So you can ask to adjust that image more if you want. And now you can see that profile image is now up there. Now, the first time you make a tutor, back here, you would click create to make the tutor. This one's already made for the biology one here. You can just click update. It'll take a second. It'll now update it. And then it will be as live as possible. So we'll wait for this update. And the update has finished. So now right here is where you see it. You can share anyone with the link. You can copy the link and share it with them. Over here, there is a little share icon. You can also share it on the GPT store. And I found students can access it a little easier if I share it in that store. Sometimes anyone with the link, it was finicky. But GPT store always worked. Then you just copy the link, send it in your Canvas shell or whatever works there. Now, and you're like, okay, if it's, you know, publicly available, how can I protect this information? Especially if you're uploading like your syllabus for students to interact with and ask questions about the schedule and whatnot. Well, in your configuration here, you can actually state like, do not interact unless the password is stated and the password is electron transport chain. And so pretty much it, you will design it so that you must say electron transport chain exactly in order to access the tutor use. And I've seen some people do that before as well. I personally haven't done it, but it's not a big deal. And now all I've shown so far is using open access textbook materials. I also mentioned that you can add all of your outlines. So for my genetics course, I use publisher textbook. So I can't just upload that. I can't just upload the publisher lecture outlines if that's what they provide as additional material. But for my genetics course, so same description here pretty much. And so down here, I now have a different knowledge database. In this knowledge database now, you see all of these files. These are my own personal lecture outlines. Like in my own language, I reference figures in them and so forth. Now there is an upload limit file wise of about 20. I think it's 20 right now. So this recording is in October 2024. So everything's constantly changing with AI and stuff, but there are 20 uploads now. And so I have 19 in here. You see on some of them, I combined some chapters together, chapters 1 and 2, 5 and 6 and so forth. And that helped reduce it. And now, so now this will interact with this knowledge database. So over here, I just made an example. Can you provide me a practice mapping question for a 3-point test cross? So this is a common problem in difficult area in genetics where students are doing 3-point test crosses and they get really confused. And, you know, you as an instructor can only make up so many examples. So right here is giving them a layout of a 3-point test cross. Now, I don't expect you to know all of this right now, but here would provide them something they can do. And now you can work through with the tutor here to work through this. So if you're really stuck on figuring out 3-point test crosses, this can give additional examples for you and your class to work through. So really, really cool how this can work here. And again, same thing, any changes, you update it. You see, I didn't generate a profile picture for this one yet. I just wanted to show you an example of one where you can upload up to 20 of your own personal files to it. So that's one big thing there. Now, that is pretty much all there is to it. And then you know, share the link, students can access it. Now you can teach them how to use it. I have a page in my Canvas shell going over how to use the tutor. Feel free to reach out if you want to see what that looks like. I also have some discussion boards based on using the tutor as well to have 4 interactions with it to dive deeper into certain concepts. And then they can reflect on, you know, what they learned from it and whatnot. And that's the discussion part. So yeah, I've used this in the classroom. I've gotten a lot of great feedback from students. They've used it to help make flashcards, their own outlines of lectures, and so forth. You can put the questions in, export it as a Quizlet file. The opportunities are boundless here for I can use it. Not only as an instructor can you make these for your class, but students, you can also make these for your, you know, notes, upload your notes if they are in, you know, file format here, and then you can create your own class tutor if your instructor might not know how. So limitations, plus users only are allowed to make them. Free users cannot make them, but they can access them with about 8 to 10 interactions with a few hour cooldown in between those interactions. I think it depends on how heavy the servers are being used at the time for OpenAI, and all that could change in the future. But accessibility wise, it is open for students, and they need to make an account. So there is that issue. They have to be okay with making an account to use it, but there's no paywall for a few interactions, which, like I said, is all you really need in the end to get your questions answered here. One gave you a full example already, which is also why forming a prompt is important. So making these conversation starters and helping teach your students how to use this is important. But hopefully now you can go make your own custom GPT tutor. If you have any questions, definitely reach out and let me know. But good luck out there and have fun. Bye-bye.